Shalom. Today we'll pick up another pair of letters and see what extended meanings we can find. You can still get your font chart with the link below. The two letters we're going to do today are Ayin and Tzadi. Remember that the Tzadi has two different forms, the final form above and the intermediate form or the beginning form, which is on the second line. Together, these two letters spell a word, which is Etz, which means tree, or wood. In Genesis 1:11, and God said, "Let the earth bring forth grass, the herb yielding seed, and the fruit tree yielding fruit after its kind, whose seed is in itself, upon the earth." And it was so. So trees have been there since the beginning. In Genesis 2:9, "And out of the ground made Jehovah God to grow every tree that is pleasant to the sight and good for food, the tree of life also in the midst of the garden, and the tree of the knowledge of good and evil." Now here is a portion from Matthew 13:24-27. "Another parable he put forth to them, saying, 'The kingdom of heaven is likened to a man which sowed good seed in his field. But while men slept, his enemy came and sowed tares among the wheat and went his way. But when the blade was sprung up and brought forth fruit, then appeared the tares also. So the servants of the householder came and said unto him, 'Sir, did you not sow good seed in your field? From whence then has it tares?' He said to them, 'An enemy has done this.' So the servant said to him, 'Would you then that we go and gather them up?' And as you know, the owner says to wait until they bring forth fruit." The point is that some things may look very similar. Even the tree of knowledge of good and evil and the tree of life, they look like trees. And so sometimes it's hard for us to tell what is going on except by discernment of the Holy Spirit or when we see the fruit. So sometimes this word is translated as wood. Genesis 6:14, "Make for yourself an ark of gopher wood, rooms you shall make in the ark, and shall pitch it within and without with pitch." So this is a kind of wood, a kind of tree. Genesis 22:9, "And they came to the place which God had told him of, and Abraham built an altar there, and laid the wood in order, and bound Isaac his son, and laid him on the altar upon the wood." So this can be any miscellaneous kind of wood. It's more about the nature of the material. Now, in Deuteronomy 21:22-23, we read, "And if a man has committed a sin worthy of death, and he be to be put to death, and you hang him on a tree, his body shall not remain all night upon the tree, but you shall in any wise bury him that day, for he that is hanged is accursed of God, that your land be not defiled, which Jehovah your God gives you for an inheritance." Most likely, the man was not killed by hanging on the tree. After he was dead, he is hung on the tree for a certain amount of time that his punishment might serve as a lesson to other people. But God says, don't hang him on the tree for too long. So this idea of hanging on a tree in a later language in Esther 7:10, "So they hanged Haman on the gallows that he had prepared for Mordecai. Then was the king's wrath pacified." So it's carried over to this idea of being a gallows, the word etz. Also translated in Ezekiel 37:19, "Say to them, thus says the Lord Jehovah, behold, I will take the stick of Joseph, which is in the hand of Ephraim, and the tribes of Israel his fellows, and will put them with him, even with the stick of Judah, and make them one stick, and they shall be one in my hand." By an extended meaning, we come to the word for counsel or advice. This is a noun form. 2 Samuel 16:23. "And the counsel of Achitophel, which he counseled in those days, was as if a man had inquired at the oracle of God. So was all the counsel of Achitophel, both with David and with Absalom." Now, Achitophel has a very fine reputation with giving counsel, with giving advice. But in this situation, it was not followed, and the Lord was using it to bring disaster on Absalom, who had rebelled against his father David. In Psalm 1:1, "Blessed is the man that walks not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor stands in the way of sinners, nor sits in the seat of the scornful." The verb to give counsel is ya'atz. You see the eights there. 1 Kings 12:8. But he forsook the counsel of the old men, which they had given him, which they had counseled him, and consulted and counseled with the young men that were grown up with him and which stood before him. So this is Rehoboam making a big mistake. In Proverbs 11:14, where no counsel is, the people fall. But in the multitude of counselors, there is safety. So the first word for counsel there, the noun, is not related to this etzah, yo'etz. It's related to tachbulot, which comes from the concept of the helmsman or the pilot of a boat steering the boat through using ropes and sails. So where there isn't any of that steerage, that proper steerage, people will fall. But in the multitude of counselors, there is safety. Now, here's a verse perhaps that you recognize with this Ya'atz counselor. Isaiah 9:6, it's verse 5 in the Hebrew text. For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. So the wonderful here is Pele, if you can read the bottom line. And it is something that is amazing, something that is really awesome or stunning. And this is speaking of course, of Mashiach. Yo'etz, this is in a participle form. The participle can be the person who is doing the action, counselor. El Gibor, the mighty, the God of mightiness. Avi'ad, Father until forever. Sar Shalom. Now we might think for a moment, how is a tree related to good counsel? There's one time where etzah is actually translated as backbone, and we're going to see more about this in a minute. Leviticus 3:9, and he shall offer of the sacrifice of the peace offering, an offering made by fire unto Jehovah, the fat thereof, and the whole rump shall he take off hard by the backbone, and the fat that covers the inwards, and all the fat that is upon the inwards. So when we think of the backbone, the spine, we want to think of something that's straight, upright, and strong, like the tree. And so this is the kind of counsel that we should have, that it is straight and upright and strong. Here is another related root, which also means advice, utz, Judges 19:30. And it was so, that all that saw it said, there was no such deed done, nor seen from that day, that the children of Israel came up out of the land of Egypt unto this day. Consider of it, take advice, and speak your minds. From Isaiah 8:10, take counsel together, and it shall come to naught. Speak the word, and it shall not stand, for God is with us. So in Hebrew, you see that the word is repeated twice, and we've been talking in other videos about Hebrew loves to do this, to double up on the syllables for emphasis. So we read, utzu etzah, take counsel together. And there's a nice song of this, and I'll put a link to the song in the show notes, so you can learn to sing the song, and then you will learn all the Hebrew words. Now, through the idea of the etzah being the backbone, we're going to connect to another word, which is etzem, which means bone. We don't usually consider mem to be a letter that can float in and out of cognate roots, linguistically related roots, but I think in this case we can see that it is related. Genesis 22:23, and Adam said, this is now bone of my bones, the flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman, because she was taken out of man. And in Exodus 13:19, and Moses took the bones of Joseph with him, for he had straitly sworn the children of Israel, saying, God will surely visit you, and you shall carry up my bones away hence with you. Now the strength of the bone and its position in the body, sort of like something that's essential, or it's the essence of something. And so quite frequently this word etzem is translated as the very same one, the self-same one, as in Exodus 12:17. And you shall observe the feast of unleavened bread, for in this self-same day, etzem hayom, the self-same day, have I brought your armies out of the land of Egypt. Therefore shall you observe this day in your generations by an ordinance forever." Now, the connection between trees and people is somewhat apparent. We both have an upright structure. We have limbs as trees have limbs. And we see this in a few examples. In Judges 9, 18 through 14, so with the death of Gideon, there was a power vacuum, and Abimelech made a decision, and he consulted with the local people that he lived with, saying, "Do you want all 70 of his sons to rule over you, or maybe just me because I'm the best?" So he had all the others killed, except for Yotam. And Yotam comes up and he gives a parable, and he's talking about the different people that might be the ruler, and he refers to them as trees one by one. So from verse 8, "The trees went forth on a time to anoint a king over them. And they said unto the olive tree, reign thou over us." And then one by one he goes through the different trees, comparing them to people. From Isaiah 65, 22, "They shall not build and another inhabit. They shall not plant and another eat. For as the days of a tree are the days of my people, and mine elect shall long enjoy the work of their hands." And finally, when Yeshua heals a blind man, and he's only sort of half healed initially, in Mark 8, 24, they asked him, "What do you see?" And the blind man looked up and said, "I see men as trees walking." So the idea of the structure and the form of the tree and the man is quite similar. Finally, there is a place in the Bible, in several places mentioned, called Etzion Gever. So you see the Etz there. In this case, it's going to be the bone. We're going to see it. And Gever is just a man. It's listed, for example, in 1 Kings 9:26, "And King Solomon made a navy of ships in Etzion Gever, which is beside Eilat, on the shore of the Red Sea in the land of Edom." If you look at the map, the place where it says Israel at the bottom, right there in the Red Sea, right in the corner there is where Eilat is, and Etzion Gever would be near there. Now, this is a topographical map, so you can see where the flatlands and the mountains are. And if you see right to the right of the eastern border, you can see the chain of mountains there. And so that's the bone, that's the spine of the man going up. And if you can use your imagination a little bit, you see the piece that's cut out, which is currently the West Bank, Judea and Samaria. You can see the face of the man facing west. The spine comes up to the bottom of his skull. So I hope that this is edifying to you. Next time we'll do some more. In the meantime, tasimata inayim al hashemayim. Keep your eye on the sky. Your redemption draweth nigh. Shalom.